Toastmasters guest and Apu in particular. Anyone makes a mistake at the initial that makes the speaker very nervous. And I think when I'm standing here reading about the goals, I pronounced your name wrong, so I hope that didn't distract you. Even if I did, I think that would be learning. If someone is trying to distract you, don't get distracted. So I still remember your first speech when you gave your icebreaker. That day I felt you broke that ice very well. Today I felt that ice is completely melted and a few all the way there and met the Satluj River. With that, I saw the emotions and feeling, enthusiasm, suspense, everything was flowing with that. Everyone was in that classroom when the Suraj, Kushal slapped Suraj. I actually felt when I was in 11th grade and what happened in my class, what used to happen, this is, I think everyone faced that way. You started your story very, very well. Everyone was touched with that. This is your second project and it talks about the organization of your speech. It asks you to create the starting opening of your speech, body of the speech and the conclusion. You started your speech with a question. The only little problem what I saw that people were still distracted. They were talking to each other or they were just trying to settle down because I pronounced the name wrong. So what you can do is you just stand here, give a long pause, make them settle down, and till the time you're standing here not giving any signal, your time doesn't start. So you can take advantage of that till the time your audience is actually looking at you and waiting for you to start. But as it, your opening was very good, the way you asked your question was good. If your audience is a little distracted, you might increase the rhythm of the voice so that everyone will be able to listen. You started thing with the suspense that one kid slapped another. Till the end, the suspense was there. I was actually expecting that you might break the suspense and tell us what happened. You use really excellent phrases saying that the systematic chaos. This is really ear-catching. I was actually stick to that. I knew that you were going to say something really good. When you said part, I was a part of all the groups and no groups. You said the scene. Individual audience was sitting there, can make out that there are a lot of groups and they were talking to each other and how you were moving and you are not a part of any group. So setting the scene, setting the characters, you described each and every character, which gave us a very good visual. It was not too much of explanation, it was not a less explanation. You gave the audience a freedom so that we can characterize, we can imagine those characters inside our body. With that, when you said it was a very nice view, and you know what I mean, I actually imagined when I was sitting in 11th grade and the boys' school was next, other side of the road. So that was we were able to sprinkle the humor in that. You set the scene, you set the characters, you definitely gave a very good message which we can take home. The closing at the end, you described that how justice is more important than unity. You restated it. When you opened it, it was a question, so it was really good. I think if you complete your story, that what happened after that and how your justice actually won, even though you have to stand outside the class, that would be really good. What you did great in your presentation, you added humor, your story was good, it was a personal story, you gave it a touch. Your emotions was flowing all through. We were all in the college, the school zone.
Thank you.